Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So I am Tave. I am a first year medical student here in the Philippines, and as you all know, my undergraduate degree is applied mathematics, major in actuarial science. And since it is the COVID-19 pandemic and the enhanced community quarantine in Luzon was extended until April 30, naisipan ko lang na to make this video for all the NMAT takers na nag-iisip kung ano na mangyayari sa NMAT nila, and sana makatulong sa kanila, and just to take this opportunity for you guys to self-study. Based sa mga naririnig ko kasi sa mga medical students and sa mga dating nag-NMAT na din, one thing na nahihirapan sila is yung sa quantitative part and sa physics part. I am not that comfortable in teaching physics, pero okay lang na, di man sa okay, pero I'm more comfortable in answering math problems because that's my degree. So for this video, we will just answer the NMAT practice set that was given to all the NMAT takers who already registered. So if you already registered for NMAT and already paid, more or less, you will get the copy of this NMAT practice set. So here, this is my iPad. So this is an iPad 6th gen. So this is what I use when I study for medical school. So I already inputted yung notability. So we'll open notability. Okay. So this is the NMAT practice set. Okay. So we will open another... Okay, we will open a blank one so we can solve yung sa problems. I'm not really sure kung ano dito yung mga kailangang sagutan or sa mga nahihirapan kayo. So, please bear with me na lang kasi sobrang haba nito. And ngayon ko na lang ulit siya sasagutan. So, bear with me sa journey na to. So for number 1, it's 96 divided by 8 divided by 4. So as you can see, madali lang to. Sobra. Okay. So gawin nyo, i-divide nyo siya from right, from left to right. So it is 96. So 96 divided by 8. So ang sagot nito is 12. So, further division, so which is 12 divided by 4, 3. So, ang sagot dito is B. Okay, so B. Next number. So, it is 5,845 plus 24,768 minus 9,651 minus 7,325. So, the tip here, just get muna yung tens and ones digit. So, it is 45 plus 68. So here is 3 carry 1, which is 113. Tapos, sa dalawang negative numbers natin, which is 51. Tapos, add mo, plus 25, sagot dito is 76. Okay? So ngayon, 113 minus 76, so 13. Tapos, this is 0, so this will be 10. 13 minus 6 will be 7. Okay? So, pwede mo na i-eliminate yung C and D. Tapos, 10 minus 7, which is 3. So, sagot dito is letter A. Okay, tama, letter A. Next. Okay, so for the next number, which is number 3, it is 515 plus 309. So, this is 4, 2, 8. Okay. Tapos yung, 400. So, 1,224. Tapos, is 423 plus 716. 11. Okay. So, 1,224 minus 1,139. This is 14. This will be 11. This is 1. So, 14, this is 5, and then 8. So, sagot is 85. So, the answer is B. Okay. So, 4. So, distribute mo muna yung mga nasa labas ng parenthesis. which is 2x minus 2y plus 3 plus x plus 3y minus 2x minus 2. Okay? So now, combine like terms tayo. So may makikita ka na agad na pwede nating matanggal. So matatanggal mo tong 2x and negative 2x. And then combine mo muna. Oh, so single na lang yung x. So x. Tapos 3y minus 2y, which is y. So makikita mo na agad. So wala na agad yung a, wala na yung c, wala na yung d. So b yung sagot. So number 5. So for number 5, it is 1 plus 6 over x plus 9 over x squared. So dito, ang rule in mathematics, in adding fraction, dapat same yung denominator. So x squared. So may x na yung second term mo. So ngayon, ang gagawin mo dito, maglalagay ka pa ng isang x para maging x squared siya. So this will be 6x over x squared. So same pa rin naman siya kasi pag kinancel mo yung x sa taas, x sa baba, 6 over x, so that's the same. So it's like multiplying by 1. So plus 9 over x squared. So para uniform yung numerator, ay yung denominator natin, x squared. So it's x squared. So this will be x squared plus 6x plus 9 all over x squared. So para ma-simplify mo siya, kailangan mo pala siya i-simplify. So, ang sagot dito is x plus 3 squared all over x squared. So, ang sagot ay D. Number 5, D. Okay. Let's go 6. For radicals, nakikita mo yan, you will just have to multiply. So, in multiplication of radicals, if you can see two radicals and then you can multiply it na lang sa, alam mo, dalawa siya. So, cube root of 3 times cube root of 3 is just equal to the cube root of 3 squared. So, mangyayari nito, it's just 3. So, to simplify, this is just 4 times 5 times 3, which is 60. Sagot ay C. Number 6C. Okay. So, number 7. So, another technique para mabilis, kapag nakakita ka ng cube of binomial, tama ba? Cube of binomial. So, x plus y cube is equal to x cube plus 3x squared y plus 3y squared x plus y cube. So for negative, nakikita mo x minus y cube. This is x cube minus 3xy plus y squared x minus y cube. Okay, so makakancel mo yung second term and then yung fourth term. So tanggal, tanggal. So this is 2x cube plus 3y squared x. 6 pala to dapat. I'm sorry. So, this is 6x. So, pwede mong malabas dito si 2x. So, 2x. So, may iwan sa loob ng first term ay just x squared. And then, may iwan dun sa second term natin ay 3y squared. So, ang sagot dito ay A. 7A. Okay, tama. 7A. So, number 8. Same rules apply kanina. So, x times x minus 2 all over x minus 2 plus 2x all over x minus 2. So, pag si-simplify natin to, this will be x squared minus 2x. Tama ba? Yeah, this is x squared minus 2x plus 2x all over x minus 2. So, pwede mo cancel to. So, ang sagot is x squared over x minus 2. So for the denominator, this is x squared minus 4 plus 4 all over x squared minus 4. So makakantayin mo to. So this is x squared all over x squared minus 4. So reciprocal mo yung denominator. So this will be x squared x minus 2 multiplied by x squared minus 4 all over x squared. So cancel mo to. So, magiging sagot mo is x squared minus 4 all over x squared. Ay, x minus 2. So, x squared minus 4, pwede mo pa siyang masimplify. So, pwede mo siyang ma-factor. So, ang factor nito will be x minus 2 and x plus 2. All over x minus 2. So, cancel mo x minus 2. Sagot is x plus 2. So, the answer is x plus 2, which is 8D. Okay. Number 9. So, this is 25 raised to negative 1 plus 25 raised to negative 2. All over 625 raised to 0 times 25 raised to negative 2. So, kapag nakakita kayo ng any raise, any number which is raised to 0, it is just 1. So, huwag kayo magpanic kahit 1 million raised to 0 man yan. Huwag kayo magpanic. Gets? So, gawin nyo ganito. So, i-rewrite nyo na lang siya, which is 25 negative 1 plus 25 raised to negative 2 all over 25 is negative 2. Okay? So, gagawin natin dito, kapag nakakita ka naman ng negative, ibig sabihin, kailangan mong 1 all over the number plus yung exponent. So, pag i-rewrite ko to, this is 1 over 25 plus 1 over 25 times 25 is 625. Yeah, 625. So, another quick tip for NMAT. So, papakita ko sa inyo to. 5 times 5 is 25. Madali lang. So, 15 times 15 is 225. 25 times 25 is 625. So, 35 times 35 is 1,225. So, paano ko siya mabilis na sagot? Kapag nakakita ka kagad ng squared tapos 5 yung ones niya, automatic, sulat mo na kagad yung 25. So, halimbawa, ang 75 times 75 ay 5,625. So, i-check natin. Tama, 5,625. So, ano yung trick dito? So, nakita nyo yung tens digit or yung naiwan. Yung naiwan. Tinanggal natin yung 5. So, 7. Ano yung next number sa kanya? 8. So, multiply mo, 7 times 8 is 56. And then, sulat mo na lang yun. Attach mo yung 25. Gets? So, that's the trick kapag squared ng any number that ends with 5. So, balik tayo dito. So, 1 over 25 plus 1 over 625. Ilang 25 ba ang nasa 625? Which is 25. So, again, rules ng fraction. This will be 25 all over 625 plus 1 over 625. And then, i-divide mo sa 1 over 625. So, ang ano nito is 26 all over 625 multiplied by 625. Cancel. 26. Number 9 is A. Tama ba? Yes. Number 9 is A. Ito ata yung may correction. Oo, ito ata yung may correction. Kasi 3. Number 10. So, 3 raised to n plus 2 plus 3 raised to n plus 3 minus 3 raised to n plus 1. So, when it comes to exponents, tas may plus. So, kapag nag-a-add ka nito, it's just like you're multiplying it. So, kapag i-rewrite ko to, this is just 3n times 3 squared. Yeah. So, same base. So, kapag same base, tapos exponent, you'll just have to add the exponent. So, 2 squared is 4, tapos 2 squared 4. So, ang ano nito ay 4 times 4, 16. So kapag 2 raised to 2 plus 2, which is 2 raised to 4, it's just 16. So 2, 4, 8, 16. Base. Okay? So plus, dito, i-rewrite na lang ulit natin yon. So this is 3n multiplied by 3 raised to 3 minus 3n multiplied by 3. So factor out mo yung 3n. So this is 3n times 3 squared plus 3n. So this is 3 raised to 3 minus 3. So nakikita nyo na. So this is 3n is 2 plus 3n, which is 27 minus 1, which is this will be 26. 3n plus 2 will be 3n times 9. So pwede mong ma-factor out si 3n. Iyon yung problem dito eh. Kasi ang problem dapat dito, hindi plus yun. Dapat this should be divide. Oo, kasi the key says it is letter C. So for us to get letter C, this should be division. Mm-hmm. Okay? So kapag dinivide ko yan, this is 3n times 9 all over 3n. 26, cancel, cancel. So this will be 9 all over 26. Which is, kapag dinivide mo siya into 3, 8, 16, 24. Okay, so nakita ko na yung error ko. So this should be 3, not 1. That's 3. So this should be 24. 24. So this is 24. 24. So this is 3 over 8. So nakuha na natin yung sagot, which is letter C. Ito yung lagi kong nire... Actually, sinend ko na to sa CEM. Nasabi ko, may mali dun sa practice set. Hindi ko sure kung yung bagong version na pinamimigay nila is already corrected. Pero what I have here is the 2014 version ng practice set nila. Hindi naman nila yearly to pinapalitan because the other version of this one is 2012 ata. Oh ata, 2012 ata. Yun yung last version nito. Okay, so number 11. Another easy problem, which is 2 minus 6 plus 2x plus x. This will be just 3x minus 4. 11 is C. Okay?